1-2, 1-2.
Congratulations on a brilliant event, and I'm really looking forward to seeing what this session, and well done everyone for turning out so beautifully. Thank you. is the first real example of people power in Leeds. What happened was, there was a march, it was called the Thousand Lads of Leeds March. And what we're seeing today is the young people dressing up to commemorate that, because what they did, they came past the town hall here, and they had cricket bats with them and footballs and other things. And they had a message for the people inside, the councillors over there and the mayor. They said, we want somewhere to play, a park, some green space, some fresh air. Because if you think of Leeds back then, it was dusty, noisy, busy, an industrial town. And it was the first real example, I think, that the people of Leeds decided that they wanted better than what they were being given. And that's why it's such an important event. The day when the people of this place said, right, enough is enough. We want better than what we've got, and we're going to make sure we get it. And they stuck at it. And you know, one of the lads who was on that march that day became the mayor of Leeds. So one of the people who was waving his cricket bat, shouting at the people in the town hall, eventually became the first working class mayor of Leeds. The first person from like an ordinary, humble background to become the mayor. And he was the person in the end who signed on the dotted line to give Leeds Lilford Park. So what a wonderful story that is, and that's why it's really important to celebrate it. I just want to thank everybody who's been involved in making this possible. The friends of Lilford Park, who do a terrific job on everybody's behalf. I am so grateful to them for what they're doing. To the council, to Healthy Arts, to the scouts, the guides. A big thank you to Lee Centurions and to Jamie Acton. If he asked you for a park, you'd give him a park, wouldn't you? You'd give him more than a park, I think, if he asked you for one. It's great to see Jamie here today, and the club always supporting everything that we do here in Leeds. Fantastic that he's here. But I just want to thank you all, and the schools particularly, for getting behind this important event today. And the last thing I want to say is, particularly to the young people of Leeds, who are the fine young people of Leeds that we have here before us today. I think the new Mayor Ashworth is within these young people, and maybe the next MP for Leeds is standing in front of me now, the person who's going to take my job, maybe, in a few years' time. I want the young people of Leeds to think, well, what do you want Leeds to be in the next 100 years? What do you want to get for Leeds in the 21st century? There's more things we need, isn't there? Train station, did somebody say before? I think we could do with one of those, couldn't we? But there's other things as well. We've got some improvements. The Leeds Sports Village is really helping improve Leeds, but we need more. And I want young people here to think, if all those years ago the young people of Leeds got some improvements, well, your generation can do the same. If it's a youth club or maybe a skate park, you often talk about a skate park, don't you? Well, why don't you get organised and get campaigning and start shouting at the people in the town hall and start shouting at me, because it's about time we heard your voice, and it's about time we did more to put Leeds back where we all want it to be. So thank you everybody for turning out this afternoon. It's a wonderful occasion where we really can feel the pride that we all have in our town. Let's enjoy the day, and let's all resolve to keep on making Leeds better in the years ahead. Thank you very much, everybody.
Hello, can you hear me? In a moment, we're going to give an opportunity for parents and school teachers to take photographs of everybody. But before we do that, we've got another very special man here today. Gentleman over here in the uniform. We'd all like to just say hello to Derek Robbins.
Hello, Derek.
Derek is here today as a representative of the armed forces. Now, the park was opened in 1915 during the World War One, and in the opening day parade, we had members of the Leeds Athletes Volunteer Force. Got representatives over here today with a splendid facial hair. So we thought we'd bring Derek along today to just now instruct you in how to march correctly. Okay, so he's going to move along the lines, and he's going to tell you how you need to stand and how you need to get ready to march, so that when we take the photographs, you're going to be looking at your best. So you all ready? I'm sure he's going to be quite strict.
Over to you. What you need to do is to look happy. There's smiles everywhere, and we don't want anybody to slouch. Now, do you know what a slouch is? not to slouch. We want you to stand upright with your chest out because you're proud and your stomach in, which is a bit harder for some of us than it will be for you. And to march along as best you can. Now, if you can march, you go with your left foot forward and your right arm forward. And you swing it to your own waist height, backwards and forwards. Now, those of you with sticks, be very careful, because if you swing your arms with a stick, you might poke somebody's eye out, and we don't want that. So, you all got the idea, look happy, stand up straight, swing your arms if you can, little ones can hold hands, can't they? Yeah? And remember, you're out in the traffic now, and the roads are busy, so do exactly what your teacher tells you to do. If they say stop, you stop. If they say go, that's when you go. Have you, anybody got any questions? All right then. Over to the...
Chelsea's won 24.
A reenactment of the opening of the park as it happened 100 years ago in 1915. Bedford High school pupils are performing this.
Welcome, but his name will live on in the history of our town. Now we have a reason to rejoice despite the ghastly war in Europe, and the 5th of June will always be a great day in the history of our town. Lee has long been famous for his industries, and we are proud of the mills and the mines, but now we must make it a more comfortable home for its people. We'll escape the dust and the dirt of the machinery and find pure air under a resting place under the shady trees. I'd now like to ask Mr. Bibby to read a short poem he has written especially for the occasion. Thank you, Your Worship. To the woods, when the balmy breath of spring wakens its nature into gladness, a thousand voices sing, the sunny mind forgets its sadness. When shady paths I tread, pine trees waving overhead, oh forest green and fair, oh pine trees waving high, how cool is your retreat, how full of rest. Thank you, Mr. Bibby. Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Bibby. Unfortunately, the park isn't finished yet. Until the war is over, we can't borrow money to build the park keeper's house, the bowling green, and the tennis court. But when it is finished, it will be one of the prettiest, I say prettiest, parks in the district. Bedford's Woods will be famous throughout Lancashire. Lee will be discovered! I now declare the park open! Thank you, Mr. Mayor. On behalf of the Park Committee, please accept this handsome silver key as a token of our worship. It is engraved with the words, Lee Park, JP June the 5th, 1915. Thank you all for your patience. This is one of the largest crowds I've ever seen in a public event in Lee. I now have great pleasure in moving a vote of thanks to the Chairman, the Mayor and all the members of the Parks Committee. We cannot thank our friend the Mayor enough. He has done great things with this park by acquiring it.
Bye.